We're here in Toronto with the Lumishade on their next tour stop here at the Phoenix. First of all, welcome to Toronto. I wish I had better weather to offer you guys, but it is what it is.
Oh, it is really pretty here today.
But
we're
it's
lucky.
Cold, but it's cold.
You know, it's fine. Where we come, we're used to these degrees of coldness. It's fine.
Look at this guy. He looked like he killed a bear on the way here, and he made his own jacket.
I killed a singer, a furry singer on the way. Oh, no, she's still here.
Wait a minute.
She's still here.
I'm not that furry.
Next question.
Wow. Like, now, this is some deep cuts that we're getting into here. So let's talk about the tour that you guys are on right now in North America, your first ever tour in North America. Early so far, but how has it been?
Really good. Really good so far. We're 5 shows in out of 25, but so far it has been amazing. We had our first Illumi pit in New York. From the first song on, they started pitting. It was really cool. Yeah.
Is it meeting your expectations?
Absolutely. It's a different experience. We've been here before, as you know, but it feels completely different because it's something we built up from the ground, and everyone's, you know, you've got a great crew, great team, and it's just really, really nice to be here.
Do you feel a little bit of extra responsibility when it's more of your baby, if you will, and like you said, it's the first North American tour? Does that add extra stress, extra weight on your shoulders?
No, I would say extra joy, to be honest.
That's nice. Yeah, actually, yes. But also, obviously, we don't have that much crew like when we are, for example, with Helvetii on the road. So, of course, there's much more things that we need to care about, think about. But really, we enjoy it every day.
So. It's more work for sure.
Yeah.
It's less time to spend on seeing the place you're at, but it's all worth it for sure.
There's a lot of stuff that goes on tour day, as you guys know, like sound check, meet and greets. And I want to talk a little bit about the meet and greet, because I always feel like that's such a cool part of the day, because you guys get to meet the fans. You get to hear firsthand what they have to say. And that's my question for you guys. What are the fans saying to you guys on this tour so far?
What are they saying?
Are they saying anything? They're
We sing for them.
You don't even know
why
we're
here. We play for
here.
Them on the meet and greet. So, and then...
Usually we don't get to talk too much. I mean, maybe you do. We usually don't get to talk to them that much because it's kind of a tight scheduled meet and greet. So we play 2 songs, acoustic versions, and then we sign stuff and we take pictures. And usually that pretty much fills the time we have. But... I don't know. Yeah, just today I had a nice chat about solo guitars with the guy. So good meet and greet.
So that was good for you. That was good for you. As you go through the process of doing these shows on this tour, where do you see you guys going forward? Do you feel like this tour will open certain doors for you guys to come back again and do this more on a regular basis and not wait a long period of time between tour visits?
Oh, definitely hope so. I mean, we have quite some people coming up to the merch after the show, like, hey, we never heard of you, but now you have a new fan. It's like, oh. So that's the best response that we can get. That's why we are here, to reach more people. And we have a visa for 1 year, so we better come back.
Yeah, you guys might as well get your money's worth.
Exactly. That's an important point, because the visas to get over here, they're pretty pricey. Yeah. So we might try to squeeze in another tour if we can. While that's valid. But also, I guess we both were surprised how many people already knew or heard of us when, like, Fabi's asking them, like, during our set, and most of the times people were like, yeah, so we're always like, oh, okay.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it seems to be, we might come back soon.
Yeah, let's hope.
I hope so. I mean, I hope this tour delivers what you guys want in order to check all the boxes so that you guys can come back. You guys are also touring, obviously, on the back of the new record that you guys released. How is that now? Like, looking back, the album is out. You guys had some time to sit on it, simmer, read some of the comments that people have had about the record, people like myself. I don't know if you read the comments, by the way. I'm just assuming you do. But how do you look back now at that process of the album being out? out and digest everything that people have had to say about it?
Yeah, I read quite some reviews actually, because I'm just very curious what people think about it.
Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
I don't know. I like to read the reviews, just even if they're bad. I mean, it's okay. It's interesting, at least. I try to not read too much of the YouTube comments in that way. I had a good friend of mine back in the days when I joined Elveti. She filtered the bad comments from the good ones, so she just read me the good comments.
Ones.
So that was actually a perfect thing to do.
Do you read comments? Do you check out what people are saying about the record when the record is released?
I just I try to find the 10 out of 10 reviews and read those. No. But I do. But mostly when I kind of stumble upon them, usually I'm already in my head. I'm thinking about the next record. But I really appreciate. If people like our new record, our music, but you know, in the end, we just do what we do. It's what comes from our heart as artists. So I see that that's what we do. That's what I'm doing, and I think this record put us in the right place. I think it's a record that shows that we are a band of many facets and colors. And I think it put us a bit more into the area of maybe a progressive corner as well, or progressive music compared to the first one. And I think people got that, and that's what I really like. That I think they're getting what we're trying to do.
The question is, do you know what you're trying to do? Because
no, not at all. Because I have no idea what I'm doing, but. It's for reviewers to put a label on something. It's our job to just put it out there and, you know.
And have fun doing it.
Yeah, absolutely.
It came across on the record that you guys were having a good time doing it. But now with touring, because you guys had the European tour, now you're doing this North American tour. Does the touring and playing these songs in front of a fan base, and in this case, a new fan base, does that help define a little bit of the path or the direction or what kind of songs you start to see that work better, the ones that perhaps don't work better? Does any of that play a role in your mind?
You go first, because my answer is pretty kind of rough.
Kind of rough. It's a no, straight out of no, right? Yeah. No, for me, for me the same. I have to say. I assume it's a no for you. There's one thing. Yes, there are songs that I feel work better or a little bit less live. Let's say. I always say Cloud Reader. I didn't think would go that well live. But I think live.
It's not true.
No.
She's lying.
Stop this interview. This interview is over.
No, it's like because
it's
Cloud Reader.
People are like, they're with you at the end.
Exactly. That's why I'm saying.
Look,
I'm saying it works really well.
No. If I don't fuck up the solo, the song goes well. Then again, I fuck up the solo every.
Now and then.
Second show. Wait, did I fuck it? No. Tonight should be good.
This is the
don't
fifth
worry.
One, so I think we're good. We're good tonight.
Yeah, I just wanted to say that it's like even working better than I thought, Cloud Reader.
That's what I'm saying.
I wanted to say this from the beginning.
Yeah.
I think you guys are saying the same thing, just in a different way.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Yeah, that's what everybody's saying. So basically, it's no.
Well,
maybe.
I agree with you. It's no. I think it's smart and it's interesting to see what works, what. Touches people more than maybe other songs, but in the end, I'd just like to quote one of my favorite guitarists, Nuno Bettencourt, and he was recently saying in a Rick Beato interview that if you do what you do for the fans, that's a lie, because we are doing this for ourselves, kind of. Of course, we love our fans and we love that people like this, but in the end, you have to do it because it's what you love to do, and if people love what you do, even like that's. Really nice, but if you, I don't think it's the right, the right way of things to try to please fans, and then work from that perspective. but from the other way around. And I think that's what he was trying to say, and I really agree with that.
Well, you can fuck up the solo tonight because you just quoted Nuno Bentancur. He's Portuguese, in case you didn't know. I'm Portuguese, yeah. So like that's my homeboy, if you will. So yeah, you can totally fuck up the solo tonight. You just got to pass.
Well,
not that you I want mean, to.
Exactly, not that I.
Not that you
want to.
Yeah. Don't try it. Don't go with that angle. Just right. Do your best. Well, it's always a pleasure talking to you guys. I wish you guys nothing but the best on this tour. All the success in the world. You guys deserve it. And I really hope that the tour, like I said earlier, checks all the boxes for you guys so that you guys have an excuse and a reason to come back again and play more songs with a longer set so that everybody can be happy. And I think that's what everybody wants. I think that's the energy that everybody wants, and I hope that's what you guys end up getting it throughout this tour of North America.
Well, thank you so much for having us.
Yeah, thank you so much. We're really enjoying it. Looking forward to Toronto tonight.
Absolutely.
And now you guys can go eat some food because I know you guys are hungry, or at least she's hungry.
Yes, I am.
Yeah, it's a good idea, though.
Yeah, all right. We'll see you guys. Go check these guys out. The tour dates will be in the description of the video, so don't miss an opportunity to see these good folks playing live their first ever tour in North America. You definitely want to be there. Check out those dates and go see them.